All right, good morning, class. Today we are going to be working on creating our locker magnet, or fridge magnet, I guess. At school, I always called it a locker magnet because the kids would make it and hang it on their locker. As I showed you yesterday, the locker magnet or fridge magnet is going to be a designed model that we can insert magnets in the backside of that allow it to hang off of a metal substance. Let's get into it. To begin with, I'm going to create a new design, and like we did yesterday, you're going to title your design, your name, the object. We're going to call this fridge magnet. And then the color you would like. Once I've done this, I'm going to go into design. Now, the biggest thing here is your design needs to be certain size so that it'll actually fit a magnet and so that it'll actually hang off of your refrigerator. Remember, we talked yesterday that if you make an object that's super tall, it's not going to actually hang off the fridge because it's going to be too tall. Due to gravity, of course. So we're going to bring this down. And the magnets we're working with are 4 millimeters thick. So we need to make our objects at least 5 millimeters thick. You could probably go up to 6, maybe even 7 with a finished magnet, fridge magnet, but at least 4 millimeters thick. That way, when we print it, we actually have a opening to put the magnet inside of. So I've made this rectangle 5 millimeters thick. This is the one I'm going to be working with. And I'm going to be making actually a simple to-do magnet. Something that I can hang on the fridge and then I can put some paper underneath it, like just a little to-do list. So you're welcome to make whatever you like. You don't have to make something so simple as this. Obviously, I expect you guys can probably get more creative if you like. So like we did yesterday, we're going to be putting in some dimensions. At least I am, because I really want it to be a certain size. I guess I should state that the magnets themselves are 4 millimeters thick, but they are 20 millimeter diameter circles. And so I'm going to bring out a circle here, a cylinder, and I'm going to make this cylinder 4 millimeters tall. There we go. So this 4 millimeter tall cylinder, which I can actually increase the sides. This is something I don't know if you notice with cylinders, but when you have a cylinder, it gives you this other option here for the drop down, and you've got this sides piece. So if you scroll this, if you put it all the way up to 64, it'll make your cylinder as round as Tinkercad can make it. It's basically the number of sides. It's all a cylinder related. If I drop this really low, let's say I go like 12 sides, make it a solid so you can see it better. It's going to go ahead and have the sides in there. You're going to see those sides show up. I can bring it all the way down to 12. That's the least number of sides. If I scroll it all the way up to 64, now I've got the most number of sides, and now it looks the smoothest. So again, I'm going to make this a hole. And this is going to be the actual spot where we're going to put the magnet in. So just like we did yesterday with keychain, where we dropped in a little a hole on one end, we're going to actually be putting in a magnet for our refrigerator magnet doohickey that we're making here. Now, I could go ahead and grab a second cylinder to make a copy of this or make one just like it, or I could duplicate it, and that's in the upper left-hand corner. On my screen, it's underneath, you can see underneath the title there, there's a series of three squares. If you tap on the three squares, that's the duplicate function, and now I've duplicated that object. So I actually have two of my magnets. I'm going to slide one underneath here, and I'll slide the other one underneath there as well. Now if I scroll up, I can see, okay, there my magnets are located, and I actually want to align those, so I'm going to tap on all three objects, 1, 2, 3, and align those three objects. So this is how you do alignings on an iPad. You actually have to tap the objects, and then you can align the objects. I want to move this over just a little. Whoops, that's not what I want to do. I want to move it, not resize it. Oops, don't want to do that either. Okay, let's try this again. just grab the object. There it is. And then I'll move it over just a bit. Remember, with the iPad, it's a little touchy, but you can get it pretty close. And so my goal here is to get them pretty close to even as far as their location. And then I'm going to tap all three objects again, do this alignment. Remember, the alignment is the upper right corner. It's kind of blue right now on my screen. It's a open rectangle and a shaded rectangle. And that allows me to get these dots, and then I can align all my objects. All right. So I've got basically the magnet part of it done. Oh, I don't want to do that. Now I just need to finish off the object. I don't want just a blank rectangle, or maybe I do want a blank rectangle, I'm not sure. But I want to add a few things to this shape. So again, I'm going to grab my work plane by hitting the work plane button in the upper right corner, and I tap on top of the object, and now whatever I bring in is going to go onto the surface of this magnet shape. So I'm going to bring in some text. Put on there, and I don't need it to be 10 tall, so I'm gonna bring it down so it's not 0.1, but 1. So it's 1 millimeter tall. That way, it actually shows up. And I'm gonna re-put these words. Like I said, I want to make a to-do list, or maybe something I can hang a to-do list off of. So I'm just gonna put the words "to do" on there, and there we go. So I will turn work plane off by tapping on the word work plane and then tapping anywhere in the screen. And then I will select my objects, to do plus the rectangle plus the two circles. And I will do an align center. All right, so that looks a little better. I actually want to move this over just a smidgen. Try to get it as close to centered that way as I can. Now, this, again, very, very simple tutorial of how to make this. I'm actually going to group these two things. So I tap on the square, which has a circle coming off of it. And I also want to group my magnets into my shape. So I tap all three of those, group. And the neat thing is now you'll see I have these two recesses that I can slide magnets into. Alright, so again, very basic tutorial on how to make a simple refrigerator magnet.